you're presented with a challenge, the likes of which you've never seen and will probably never see again. You don't even think of the morality of it. You're just completely swept away by the flattery of it and the juices inside you, which make you want to do it as the artist you are innately. You don't think of anything else.
What a conflict. I mean, gosh, I can't imagine being presented with that opportunity. On one hand, I really would want to do it, but then I'd probably say, well, I'm committing a crime and lying. And
it depends, but my guess would be no, you if you're good, you would do it. I discussed this with Levinson, Barry Levinson.
Right.
I discussed it with
He made Wag the Dog, right? Yeah.
Yes. Spielberg, of all people, believe it or not, yes.
So wait, Wag the Dog.
Coppola, Scorsese, even Woody Allen, I discussed. There isn't one of them who wouldn't do this.
Right. And did that? So Barry Levinson must have been influenced by this whole. He must have known. So that's Wag the Dog is about this whole idea. I mean, that's why
the character was named Stanley.
Right, and he gets killed at the end because he demands credit. But tell me about the making of it. So, was it difficult? I mean, committing the greatest fraud, what you want to call it. I'm not saying
a lot about that at the time.
I know, so I'm not making moral judgment, but making this huge, ambitious, technical faux landing, was it harder than 2001? Was it very difficult? I mean, what was the experience like? Artistically, practically, emotionally, what was
nothing
it like?
Nothing was harder than 2001.
So 2001 was harder than faking the moon landing?
It actually was.
Because you learned things on 2001 and...
Yes. I mean, 2001 was very ambitious, and that's not to say that faking the moon landing was not ambitious, but I learned things making 2001, which is why I got this gig in the first place, right?
Right, right, that makes sense. So, so what was the experience?
It was easy for me because, first of all, I didn't think a whole lot about the morality of it, as I said. If I had, I might have been more... hesitant, more stifled in my work, but I didn't. And I could see that Neil was, actually. He was bothered by it.
More than Buzz Aldrin or anyone else involved?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
About
because in a way, everything was going to center around him. He was the one who was supposed to come down off the ladder and announce the step for mankind and what have you. He sensed that this was going to be a life-changing experience for him, and I mean on a major scale. Actually, he was rather tortured by it the rest of his life.
Really? I mean, is that why you didn't have interviews?
Yes, that actually began to affect my own perception of it, watching what happened to him.
Okay, in what way? Just seeing the deterioration of him? Was he depressed? Or
he was depressed. He was drinking heavily, bitter, scared, just phobic, avoiding people.
And that guy Bart Sibrell or something tried to get him to swear in a Bible.
When I say he affected me, that's why there was so much time in between films for me. Between Full Metal Jacket and The Shining and Full Metal Jacket was about 6 years. Between Full Metal Jacket and Eyes Wide Shut is 13 years.
Yeah.
And a lot of that time was spent just...
like just emotionally processing?
Yes. It became very conflicting for me. I was proud of my work, but at the same time... and this was a lot because of Neil's influence. Not consciously. He didn't do this to me consciously. But I spent a lot of time with him, and each time I did, I became more and more bothered, troubled by my own participation in this.
Okay. Well, what would he say? I mean, did he explain the source of his depression?
On the verge of tears. He did not cry. I won't say he cried. But he was on the verge of tears so many times because of what he did.
I mean,
what he participated in. It's almost as if he thought up the idea, you know?
Right. He felt that guilt.
He was almost...